The next topic we'll cover in this video is chaining requests together, how we make parent-child requests using the batch controller, where a child subrequest can access the information from a parent subresponse. In order to utilize this, we're going to demonstrate how to identify which subrequests are parents. These parent subrequests are executed first, so that the subsequent child request can use the content of the parent subresponse. Additionally, we'll demonstrate how to retrieve information from parent subresponses. The child subrequests are going to use JSON path to query the parent subresponses for the information from them. One of the most common use cases for parent-child subrequests is using web IDs from one subrequest to build out the resource for another subrequest. As a note, JSON path was developed independent of OSIsoft and is utilized in a number of applications, though we do support most, if not all, JSON path syntax. In this example, we're going to create an element, then query for the newly created element from the parent subrequest. I'll remove the get home page request, and we'll add a new subrequest for query element. In this case, we want our method to be get. Next, in order to specify that this request is a child to another, we'll add the parent IDs parameter to our subrequest. The parent IDs parameter takes an array of all subrequests that need to be completed before this subrequest can be executed. In our case, we only have one other subrequest, which is the create element subrequest. This is also the subrequest that needs to be completed first, so we'll enter this subrequest ID into the parent array ID. This is one of those times that it's useful to have helpful ID names for the subrequest rather than 1, 2, 3. Next, we need to identify what information we'd like to retrieve from the parent subrequest. We'll use the parameters field for the subrequest to do this. The parameters field also takes an array of values. In our case, we need to only retrieve one piece of information. This is where our JSON path syntax comes in. We're going to start this off with a dollar sign, which represents the top-level JSON object. In our case, the top-level JSON object is going to be the entire response. Then we use dots to access a particular property of the object beneath this top-level object. So, if we want to access a particular subrequest, we'll need to use the syntax $.subrequestID. We can use additional dots to reference properties of the subrequest, and this is the method we're going to use for retrieving the URL out of a parent subrequest. As a note, each JSON path must select exactly one token, or the value of that property. In this case, we can use a previous response to take a look at the content of the response so we know what path we'll need. From our last video, if you recall, we created a new element, new blue. Taking a look at the content of the response, we see the header with the URL for the newly created element. This is exactly what we're going to need for querying that element. Lastly, we need to build out the URL that we'll need for the child request in the resource parameter of the child request. We'll use substitution with syntax similar to C# string building to substitute in the value of the property selected in the parameters of the subrequest. So, we use a 0 enclosed by curly braces, which is going to be substituted with whatever value is returned by the JSON path specified in the first index of the array of the parameters property. We can have additional substitutions in the resource from the parameters array if we need, but we're going to focus on one for now. So, to recap, in our case, we plan on retrieving the URL from the create element call. Then, we're going to reference it using the JSON path syntax and the parameters, and use that as our URL for the resource. let's update our name of the element that we're creating to new yellow, so that we're not trying to create an element that already exists. I'll also need to add the elements endpoint to this URL. Let's execute the request. We can see in the subrequest that our getElement response is 200. In the content portion of this response, we can see all of the information about this newly created element, including the path. So now we've confirmed that we're able to use the parent subrequest and return to us the information from that parameters array